I mean with your real challenge.
I want to talk a little bit about the name that we're giving him, Noam Yaal. So Noam means pleasant, charming, and our hope for our son, if he was here, I'd tell him, that's okay. Our hope for our son is that he's a pleasant, wonderful person, who's charming, who adds light to the people around him, who is an optimist, who sees the good in life, and really brings others up by them being around him, who has a good life and who does good things and is just a wonderful addition to the world, where people feel better being around him and people want to be better and stronger being around him. So that's one of the reasons we chose the name Noam. And his middle name, Yaal, means he will ascend. So what is it to be good in the world if there's not also trying to be the best you can be and reaching up to be like God? So what we hope for our son, Noam Yaal, is that he's a pleasant, wonderful person and a mensch, but that he doesn't forget that it's not just about the world, the physical world, but that we should always be striving to be the best we can be, and that we're only the best we can be with the relationship with God, and that he's really looking up and experiences tremendous spirituality and inspires others to be the best they can be, to ascend and to have a very strong relationship with God. So our son, I was thinking, Noam, our family will appreciate Noam after getting used to the name of Salah. Noam is being pretty easy. Our son, Bitsal Aria means lion in the shadow of God. So just like his big brother, his wonderful big brother. Who's the big brother? He was like his big brother, whose name signifies lion, is physical and powerful and able to do lots of things in the shadow of God, only looking up and knowing that you're only who you are because of God and because of your relationship and because God has given you so many gifts. Like that, we wish that our son, Noam Yaal, is able to be a wonderful, pleasant person, to be a mensch, to be an optimist and really add joy and life to the world and do so in a way that reaches up to God. And really, we want him to be a beautiful Jewish boy and raised to be a beautiful Jewish boy, beautiful Jewish man, just like our little bit solid hearing of today.
When we were having our first child, I had asked Jennifer to write down some names that she thought she might like, you know, boys' names and girls' names. And I came up with 8 or 9 of each. And Jennifer only put down 4 boys' names. And Noam, she accidentally put down twice. So it was really only 3 names, but she put Noam twice. So in my mind, that was, I don't know whether it was intentional or not, but that's what she said, that that's a name she likes. And that if we have another child, maybe that's the name that she's going to want. So I was not surprised that our son is called Noam. We're very thankful to so many people, and first I want to thank God, obviously, for being here. It's been a very eventful past 3 years. It's just a little over 3 years ago. We actually had our last Sheva Bracha at Sudash Yeshiva in this room, and celebrating here. And then a year and a half ago, we were celebrating Bitsal's first year, and now, another year and a half later, Noam's first year. So we have so much to be thankful for and grateful for, and we're not forgetting how lucky and blessed we are to be able to celebrate so many simchas. I also obviously want to thank my wife. there are many women who, after having one baby and taking care of a little baby at home, say, let's do it again and have another one right away. And so obviously I'm very grateful to you for everything. And for our little boys. having a second baby is a lot harder than the first because you have to worry about what you're going to do with the other baby when you go into labor. So I want to thank Judy, Jennifer's mom, specifically for taking such good care of Itzala so that I could be focused on helping Jennifer and being with her in the hospital. We had a very impromptu Shalom Zohar because Noam was born Friday afternoon, so thank you to all the guys who came and helped with that. In this community, it's amazing how many people, when you have a baby, within a day or two, sign up to bring meals to the couple with a new baby. Jennifer has 25 days straight of meals already set up. So thank you to all the women and in the community, Deborah, for organizing it and making that possible. And we are very grateful to that. And to everyone here for coming and celebrating with us. Especially our family, people who flew in just for today, and everyone near and far for coming and celebrating with us. Thank you so much.